In this video, I want to talk about the Tregs, the T regulatory cells. First of all, what are these? T regulatory cells are the brakes of the immune system. They suppress the immune response. Where do we get them from? So T regulatory cells are differentiating from a naive CD4 T cell. So you can think about it kind of a type of T helper cell. It's also an effector cell. So a naive T cell needs to become activated in order to differentiate into a T regulatory cell. But this happens under very specific circumstances. And let's look under which scenario such a naive CD4 T cell could differentiate into a T regulatory cell. So it all needs to start in the periphery because we need a DC to activate this naive T cell. So let's suppose there is no infection going on and this dendritic cell just eats up stuff that it can find. Therefore, it will also eat up, for example, food antigens and present it via MHC2. And eventually, it might get into the lymph node. And then it could happen that this dendritic cell that now made its way into the lymph node presents this food antigen via MHC class 2, and we're gonna get a signal 1 via this activation of the T cell receptor and the interaction with MHC 2. Now, this is gonna happen all the time, and what is gonna happen next? Well, there is no infection going on, so there's no pathogen around. Therefore, there's hardly any co-stimulation, and so this T cell will just die by apoptosis. It's going to drive itself into energy. But what could potentially happen, that under certain circumstances, there is a little bit of B7 on the surface of this dendritic cell. And actually, the dendritic cells have, immature dendritic cells, have very low levels of B7. It's not enough to provide co-stimulation to generate effector T helper cells or T killer cells, but it could be enough to activate a naive T cell with this little food antigen. And now there is no pathogen around. And this is the most important thing to realize. You're never going to get a T regulatory response if there's pathogen around. So we are here just seeing food antigen or other self-antigen. So there's no pathogen around. And under these circumstances, the dendritic cell would make some TGF-beta. And as we're going to make now cytokines and there's co-stimulation, this naive T cell would differentiate into a T regulatory cell. A T regulatory cell makes mainly TGF-beta, which inhibits all T cell responses, and also IL-1, which inhibits particular Th1 differentiation. So the T regulatory cells are really a layer of tolerance. Because if you think about it, we want to have a system in place that does not go crazy and does not initiate a huge immune response if you are just seeing food antigen or some self-antigen. So in this scenario where we have no pathogen around, and in case the B7, this very low B7 expression on the dendritic cell is close to the TCR-MHC interaction, we could get a signal too. And the dendritic cell makes TGF-beta, and that leads to the differentiation into a T regulatory cell. This concludes the video on T regulatory cells.